Assalamualaikum, my name is Mehmood Sadin. You're watching Introduction of Biology with Mehmood Sadin. Stay home and stay safe in this pandemic. We have studied chapter number 4 in which we today we study the other phenomena of passage of molecules into and out of the cells. These phenomena are facilitated diffusion, filtration, endocytosis and exocytosis. Before starting the lecture, if you're new on my channel, please subscribe to my channel so you can get my latest videos. So let's go to the screen. We have started passage of molecules into and out of the cell. In previous lecture, we study about the diffusion. First, we study about the facilitated diffusion. What is facilitated diffusion? It is same like the diffusion that in this process, molecules is also moved from high concentration to the low concentration. But the difference is that many molecules do not diffuse freely across cell membrane. Why they do not diffuse freely across the cell membrane? Because of their size and the charge of the molecules. As you can see the diagram that is show the transportation of molecules. So there is a question that how they are moved. The answer is that such molecules are taken into or out of the cell with the help of protein, that is transport protein. The light blue color shaded a transport protein and the dark blue color are molecules which are moved from the transport protein. Where it is present? It is present in the cell membrane. Now, the definition of facilitated diffusion is that when a transport protein moves a substance from higher concentration to the lower concentration, this process is called facilitated diffusion. Again, repeat the definition of facilitated diffusion, that the when a substance move transport protein move a substance from higher concentration to the lower concentration, this process is called facilitated diffusion. The rate of facilitated diffusion is higher than the simple diffusion. The rate of facilitated diffusion is higher than the simple diffusion. Like the diffusion, facilitated diffusion is also the type of facilitated diffusion is also the type of passive transport. Diffusion is the type of passive transport. Facilitated diffusion is the also the type of passive transport. Because but why? Because there is no expenditure of energy in this process. The topic of osmosis is a little bit lengthy, that's why we take this topic to the next lecture. So the next topic is filtration. What is filtration? The definition of filtration is that filtration is a process by which small molecules are forced to move across the semi-permeable membrane with the aid of hydrostatic water pressure or blood pressure. So understand the definition that small molecules, not large molecules, small molecules. Why not large molecules? Because the size of holes of semi-permeable membrane is small. So the large molecules would not pass through it. In definition, the next thing is forced to move across semi-permeable membrane. It means that the small membrane not freely move, that the small molecules not freely move across the semi-permeable membrane because they are forced to move across semi-permeable membrane. Now there is a question that through which pressure they move. The answer is the hydrostatic pressure. Hydro means water. It tells that the pressure is for water, not for animals, for plants. And blood pressure for animals. Hydrostatic pressure is for plants and blood pressure is for animals. In book, they take the example of animals that in animal body, blood pressure forced to move water and dissolved molecules that are dissolved in water through a semi-permeable membrane. Is dissolved in molecules that through semi-permeable membrane of the capillary wall cells. In filtration, the pressure cannot force large molecules. I tell the reason of your of this because of the small pores. You can see the diagram of filtration in which this is the diagram of animal cell in which through blood pressure the small molecules pass through it. The next topic is extract transport. Because I don't want to take this lecture lengthy, that's why I take this topic to the next lecture. So in our next lecture, we study about the chapter number 4, we study about the osmosis and the active transport. So the next topic is endocytosis and exocytosis, and this is the last movement of molecules. First we study about the endocytosis. That what is endocytosis? Endocytosis is the process of cellular injections of bulky material by the infolding of cell membrane. Let us understand the definition. The word endocytosis means to take in. Endocytosis means to take in. What to take in? The bulky material. What is bulky material? Bulky material means large molecules. Like if you take a molecule of water and a droplet of water, tell me which is the larger? Yes. Droplet of water, because it contains thousands of water molecules. Now there is a question that how they are intake. The answer is by infolding of cell membrane. By folding of cell membrane, we take the bulky material. Intake the bulky material. Now there are two types of endocytosis. First is phagocytosis, and the second one is phenocytosis. Phagocytosis means cellular eating, means cell intake the solid materials, and phenocytosis means cellular drinking, means cell intake the liquid material. In phagocytosis, cell intake the solid material. In phenocytosis, cell intake the liquid material. This is the endocytosis. Now we study about the exocytosis. That what is exocytosis? Its name is telling that. Something is taking out from the cell. In endocytosis, we take in our cells, and in exocytosis, this is the opposite of endocytosis, in which we take out from the cell. Exocytosis is the process through which bulky material is exported. In endocytosis, bulky material is imported. In exocytosis, bulky material is exported. We have studied that. What is bulky material? Large molecules. It may waste from the cell that is exported. The benefit of exocytosis is it increase the cell membrane. But how they increase the cell membrane? The answer is when cell intake the bulky material, it take a membrane around the bulky material. How they increase the cell membrane? The answer is when cell intake the bulky material, it make a membrane around the bulky material. When they are exported, they comes near the cell membrane. After some time, the membrane of bulky material is removed, and they from it are added, and this membrane of bulky material added in the cell membrane. That's why the bulky material comes out from the cell, and the size of the cell membrane increases. On the next slide, there is a diagram of endocytosis and exocytosis. This is the diagram of exocytosis and endocytosis, in which you can see that by the process of endocytosis, the bulky material are added in the cell, and by the process of exocytosis, the bulky material are exported out from the cell, in which they are very large molecules which are added by the process of exocytosis. And very large molecules are exported by the process of exocytosis. Bulky material added by the endocytosis, and the bulky material exported by the exocytosis. So that's all.
Our today's lecture is finished. If you like my video, please like it. And if you have any query about the topic, please tell me on comment. Once again, if you are new on my channel, please subscribe to my channel so you can get my latest videos. So we meet on the next lecture. Till then, Allah Hafiz.